Hello everyone, my name is Arohi and welcome to my channel. So guys, in my today's video, I'll show you how you can perform instant segmentation using YOLO V9. Instant segmentation is a computer vision task, and the goal of instant segmentation model is to put a mask on each detected object in the image. So it is a pixel wise classification, and there are various instant segmentation models like Maskar, CNN. You can perform instant segmentation using various YOLO models, like using YOLO V5, YOLO V7, YOLO V8, and then we have Segment Anything model. Okay, and there are some other instant segmentation models also available in the market, but today we will focus how we can perform instant segmentation using YOLO V9. And let's understand why we should perform instant segmentation using YOLO V9. Because lightweight instant segmentation models like YOLO V5, YOLO V7 or YOLO V8, they face a challenge known as information degradation during the forward pass. Okay, so this degradation occurs because these models use downsampling operations in their architecture, and downsampling operations like normally they use this pooling layer or strided convolutions. Okay, these operations reduce the spatial dimension of the input image to create a compact feature representation. Now let's understand this in detail. Spatial information degradation means losing some of the small details in the picture when we make it smaller. And in YOLO models, we shrink the image to make it easier for computer to understand. But when we do this, we lose some of the fine details. This can make make it harder for the model to accurately detect object or to put a mask on them, especially when the objects are small. So while making the image smaller helps the computer work faster, we need to be careful not to lose too much important information. So this issue of information loss is the main goal of YOLO V9. To address this information loss issue, YOLO V9 use the generalized efficient layer aggregation network, which is called GLAN also, to achieve superior parameter utilization and computational efficiency. So YOLO V9 mainly focuses on addressing the information loss issue. How YOLO V9 handles this information loss issue? It does with help of programmable gradient information and reversible function. And if you want to know what is this programmable gradient information and what are these reverse functions, then I have a separate video in which I have explained the YOLO V9 paper. This is the video, you can check it, and from there you can understand how these different things work. Okay, now let's try to implement the YOLO V9 model for instant segmentation. First, I'll show you how we can use this YOLO V9 instant segmentation model, pre-trained model first. Okay, once you understand how it work, the instant segmentation model, then I'll show you how to work with a custom data set. So this is a step-by-step tutorial. Now let's start by creating a environment, because whenever you want to run any code, you need to download few packages which you need to run that particular application. Okay, so this is the YOLO V9 official repo. We need to clone this repo, and in this repo we have a requirements.txt file. From here we will install all the requirements. So I have created a separate environment to work. Let me open that environment. So my code is in D drive, so I'm entering in that, and in that I have a folder with this name, and in this folder I have created my separate environment, and inside this folder only I have cloned this YOLO V9 GitHub repo. Let's enter in this folder. Now I am activating the environment. So you need to create the environment first, and then you can activate it like this. So my environment name is this, my VENV, and here you can see the environment is activated. Now let me show you the Python version I'm using. So the Python version is 3.12.3, and if you want to check like which torch version I'm using and if it is compiled with CUDA or not, let's check that. For that, just write Python and hit enter. Now import torch. So once you import torch, now let's write torch dot underscore underscore version underscore underscore and hit enter. You can see my PyTorch version is 2.2.1 and it is compiled with CUDA 11.8. Now let's check the GPU which I'm using. So for this tutorial, I'm using NVIDIA GeForce RTX 4080. Control Z and hit enter, you'll be out of this shell. Next thing is to clone the GitHub repo, and for that just click here and then you can copy this thing from here and write git clone and then paste that link and hit enter. You will see a YOLO v9 folder inside this directory. Okay, now let me open my YOLO v9 underscore env folder to show you that I have cloned my GitHub repo over there. Okay, let's go back to the folder here. Inside this folder here, this is my YOLO v9 repo. Okay, and now we have the repo. You just need to enter in that folder. So here is my YOLO v9 repo. Here you will install the requirement, and for that you will write pip install hyphen r requirements dot txt and enter. By running this command, you will have all the packages installed in this particular environment. Now you are ready to run this YOLO v9 code. Now let's check the YOLO v9 pre-trained model for segmentation. Okay, so guys, before that, just click on this YOLO v9 repo, and inside that you will see different folders and files, and here you will see a folder with the name of segment. So all the segmentation code, if you want to see what is the code for segmentation, you can click here and you can see that. And this train.py file will help you to train your custom model. Using this predict.py file, we can put mask on the input videos or the images. Before testing this code, you also need to download the segmentation weights, right? The pre-trained weights, because we want to test with the pre-trained weights first. So you just scroll down and you have to come under this instance segmentation section, and this is the model. Just click on it and you will have it. Download this model and then place this model in your directory. Now let me show you where I have it. See here. So this is the pre-trained segmentation model, and this model is trained on COCO dataset, and using this model now we will perform the testing. So this is the command Python, and then from segment folder we want to use predict.py file, and the source here I have this image test underscore img image. On this image I want to perform the testing. I want to put mask on this image. And then this is the image size. Device 0 means I want to work on GPU, and the weights. So this is my weight file name. Let's hit enter and see. So the results are stored at this location. Now let's open it and see. Go to the folder, and then we have a runs folder here. Then predict seg folder exp3, and this is the test image. Okay, so now let me show you the input image also, this image. Okay, so this was our image. Okay, and this is our output of our model. So this is how it performed instance segmentation. Now let's see how we can work with our custom model. So for that, first thing is dataset, and this is the folder of my custom dataset. Click here and you will have two folders, train and valid. Inside train you will have images and the corresponding labels in the labels, and we have all the labels in txt format because YOLO accepts the data in, and data annotations in txt format. And zero, this first zero means the class id, like 0, 4, like this. And then we have these masks detail annotated masks. Okay, So under images you will see the images, and then under labels you will see the corresponding labels. In the same way you can check for valid also images and labels. So guys, I took this data set from RoboFlow and I have given the link in description section. You can just pick the data set from there and try. And if you want to work with your data set, then you have to, you know, annotate your data set in the format which YOLO accepts, and that is a TXT format. Now let me tell you about the data set which I'm using. So you know that the training images are present at this location, validation images are here, and the test images are here, and the number of classes are 6, and these are the classes I want to detect and put masks on: ball, bat, gloves, helmet, pads and stumps. Okay, and as I've told you, like, I took this data set from RoboFlow. So yeah, these are the classes. Now we will train our model on this data set. To train the instance segmentation model, where is the code? It is under the segment folder only. We have this train.py file. We'll use this train.py file to train our model. Okay, so open command prompt, paste this command: python segment, from segment folder we want to use this train.py, workers 8, device 0, batch size is this. You can change the batch size, let's suppose if you're facing some resource issues or memory, out of memory issues, then you can change the batch size. And then this argument data, here you have to give the path of your data.yaml file, where we have mentioned the path of training images, validation images and test images. We have also mentioned the number of classes we have and the name of those classes. That file name we are giving here, and then the image size. Then guys, in this configuration argument, under this configuration file we are providing the path of this file. So this file, what it is, let's see it. So let's open this YOLO V9 and then segment. Okay, YOLO V9 and then models and then segment. Here this is the file. So this is the custom file which I have created, and what I did is I just created another copy of this file and then rename it to this, and let's open it. And here I have only mentioned the number of classes 6. Earlier it was 80, because that this configuration file was related to COCO dataset, so the number of classes were 80 over here. Now we want to work with our custom dataset, and our dataset has only 6 classes, so I have mentioned 6 over here and then save it. Okay, after that let's go back to our command here, right? Then just write the number of epochs you want to train your model, and then hit enter. Training will start, and after training you will see this kind of screen. Now our results are stored at this location. Now let's open it and see our trained model. So our trained model is in runs folder, trainsec, and this here is our model, and this is a confusion matrix of our model. So we have these 6 classes, right? And if you want to see the results, like what is the map value when the threshold value is 50, and what is the map value when the threshold value is between 0.5 to 0.95, you can see that over here. And now let's trained weights are stored in this weights folder. We will use this best.pt to make predictions. Now we will use this best.pt model to put a mask on our custom images now. So let's do that. To test our model, let's go back to the command prompt again, and here we will run our test command. So this is the command: python segment predict.py, and then source 1.jpg. this is the image I want to perform testing on, and then the image size, device, and here. Now this time in this weights we are giving the path of our trained model, right? Now let's hit enter. So this kind of output you'll see. Now let's go to the folder and see the output. Runs predict sig, and here exp, okay, not this one, exp2, here is the output. Let's see Now let me open the input image also so that you'll see what kind of input and output we are getting. And our input images, so our test images are here. So this is the first image, and for this image for this input image, this is the output we got. Now let's check the next image. So this is our second image. For this image, let's see what is the output. So this is the output. Okay, this is how you can perform custom image segmentation using YOLO V9, and I have given the link in description section. You can get this code and try it. I hope this video is helpful, and guys, if you like my content, please like, share and subscribe my channel. Thank you for watching.